Last night was the first time in 2 weeks where I got over 10 hours of sleep. We woke up at 10 o'clock and we fell asleep at like 11:30 and it was beautiful. We are still in Saskatoon. Room cleaning's here. Before we were so rudely interrupted, Patrick is here. We are still in Saskatoon and today we are officially 20 hours out from my biggest powerlifting competition ever in my life, forever. The Western Canadian Powerlifting Championships, baby. This morning we stepped on the scale and a miracle happened. Although my scale is a little bit heavier than, lighter than the IPF scales, we weighed in at 163 pounds, baby! I still love you, my friend, with you every moment. I want you so bad. Oh, oh my God! Fuck it! What did I tell you? 162.8 pounds, and we have to be 163 for the competition, meaning I gotta cut one more to make sure that I am in that range. Oh my God, I am so relieved, because as you guys know from the last water cut video, we weighed in at this exact same time out from the competition at 172 pounds. So I am saving myself so much pain and suffering. The original plan was to come here and do so much water cutting with the diuretics and the laxatives and the hot baths and the sauna and the steam room. We are still gonna kinda do some of that, but this time not going to a point of dying, but just kinda before that, because lowering your weight, cutting water is not as dangerous if you do it in a regulated amount and you get it all done and rehydrate well, and it's a competitive edge. The lower your weight when you weigh in, the higher the points you get. Which brings us to our first meal of the day. Forehead transition. Woo! First meal of the day and last meal for the next 19 hours. What we got here is this delicious crunchy peanut butter. We're gonna be having 10 scoops of this. And here we got a beautiful consistency of this protein sludge. Oh God, doesn't that just look great? We have gold standard 100% whey protein, 3 scoops of that with only about half this cup filled of water. The water cut starts now. This is gonna be a total of 1500 calories, 40 grams of carbs, 150 grams of protein, and over 100 grams of fat, which is what we gotta do to prep for cutting this weight. No carbs, keep the water out of the system, and lots of protein and fat to rebuild that muscle and keep the body so satiated. So this is gonna be my first bite of the day. Last meal of the day. Can't eat for the next 19 hours. Gonna be starving just a little bit. The plans for the rest of the day are to stay in the hotel, absolutely relax, do a lot of self-myofascial release, muscle therapy, and get the mind so ready. Starting to calm down after that hype this morning of sleeping for, oh my gosh, 10 hours. We are wearing the BC provincial shirt with the headband, and I think the biggest problem now is just deciding which t-shirt we're gonna wear tomorrow for the meet. We're either gonna wear the BC competitive meet tee to represent the province, shout out to everyone from BC cheering me on at home, or we're gonna wear the meet tee if it's tight enough and if it's black. Cause you gotta match the singlet and you gotta look thick. Okay, first bite of the day, last meal going down. Oh, I'm so hungry, but that is so disgusting. I'm gonna switch back and forth between the peanut butter and the... Yeah, I don't really have too many plans to record today. I'm just gonna show you guys what we're gonna do for the water cut. Planning to, after we finish this, to just relax, do a lot of video editing. I was planning on originally, doing some homework, some schoolwork, and stuff to prep for the year, blah, 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 during this travel time, but just realizing how much I'm going to regret it during the meet that I didn't spend all the time rehabbing and recovering. I'm doing none of that. So back and forth, peanut butter and this. Oh my god. We left this in the fridge last night. That is so good. It's crazy. Literally this whole diet. 10 days ago, we started off at 177 pounds. And this morning we weighed it at 163. That is crazy. With the food here, we're probably going to go up by just a pound, which is good. I'm also allowing myself to have a pound of this water. I don't know how many ounces, I'll search that up later. But first, and probably the last sip of water for the day. We're only going to be sipping on this through the day as necessary. If I feel like dying, I'm going to have a little bit. But you really don't realize how much you miss water until you're deprived of it. Same with anything, but beginning of the week when I was on like 3 gallons, I was so ready to stop. And now I wish I could just go back because I was feeling good, hydrated, and now I'm dying. Like, lips are literally already crusting over. That's how you know you're getting dehydrated. So the plan for today, relax, sit in bed, edit, watch movies, edit, laxative to lose a free pound, pound and a half. And if we are not around 161 pounds by around, I'd say like 9 or 10 o'clock at night, we're going to bump up the hot baths to just sweat out the last remaining weight. Because I want to be a little bit under the weight class. I don't want like any surprises. I want to make sure that I do have the possibility of making weight. Oh, that's so good. That's so freaking good. This whole cut for the meat, I've only been having like 50 grams of fat. And hallelujah, baby. Okay. I'm going to finish this meal up. Be really happy that I still have food for once, for the last time. And I'll see you guys when I do something interesting else. Peace!
What the hell is this?
So, you see, Damien did not want to leave the room today. So, we gotta improvise. And of course, I got some tacos.
Oh my god. You know I can't eat food today. What are you doing,
sorry,
bro?
I'm sorry.
You did. Wait, there's another box?
There's another box, man.
No, what is it?
I also got some quesadillas.
You kidding me? Okay, I literally thought I was full after the morning meal. I'm starving again now. I hate you.
Sorry, so sorry.
God, I hate you so much. What do you rate that?
Huh?
What do you rate that?
I'm guessing with the chicken first.
Oh, okay, cool. Does this bring you pleasure? Just eating delicious food in front of me?
Definitely a 9 out of 10. Oh yeah.
God, I hate you.
Saskatoon, man.
six p.m. right now, water cut is going pretty well. We're down to 162.2 pounds, what it says on my scale, so we still got about 2 or 3 to go to make sure that we hit this weight. Me and Patrick here, doing some editing. Hi, Patrick.
Hello.
Probably gonna edit up for the next hour or so, and then gonna go outside to the beautiful plains of Saskatoon and go for a little walk to loosen up the body, get everything feeling good. Lower back is super sore and tight right now, so I shouldn't even be sitting, but I gotta get this time lapse. Just recorded a minute and a half of this clip, but turns out the camera was never on. Down to 161.8 pounds. It is 8 o'clock right now. Me and PMOC Strength just finished a good hour and a half of doing some editing, and right now we're uploading episode 3 of the Road to Westerns. Just finished editing it. Yes, I'm still on episode 3, so I got like 5 or 6 or 7 more to not only transfer from my camera to my computer and edit, but to make a thumbnail for and upload. We're about to go downstairs right now, meet up with one of the other BC competitors, Martin Nikolov, in the 83 kilogram category. Hopefully, he brings home the gold for us tomorrow too. I want to go for a little walk, loosen up the joints, loosen up the muscles. Come back, see how much we weigh, wearing a hoodie, maybe we'll sweat a little bit. Take a laxative for sure, and if we are still overweight there, we will go to the hot baths. 9:48 right now, got back from our walk, feeling a lot more loose and ready for tomorrow. We met up with a couple other of the competitors that's gonna be competing with us in the sub junior category. Super nice guys, super dope competitors, and I think they're gonna put up a great fight for tomorrow. It looks like if we do our best and they do their best, it's gonna be almost tied for the top overall spot. But that is not gonna be the priority, as just winning my weight category is the main thing. No, the main thing is making weight. So speaking of making weight, we're about to go do the secret trick of the trade. Hit some laxatives, baby.
Oh god, oh my god, oh my god, holy shit. Oh my god. So the way that these laxatives work is after you take them, in 2 or 3 minutes after you take them, they start activating, and you're gonna lie down on your stomach and clench like you've never clenched before for 20 minutes, and it is the hardest thing you will do mentally and physically in your life, and then you go release. Hopefully we lose up to 2 pounds like this. Right now I'm gonna finish watching this episode of South Park to get my mind off things, but I'm in a strenuous amount of pain. Okay, cut it. Oh my god, that's a lot. It's gonna come out. Go! Oh my god, I can't take it. It's been 15 minutes. Oh god. Oh, God! Oh, yeah, you can cut.
Okay, so, long story short, the laxative worked. I'm down to 160.5 pounds right now. Right now I have a decision. Either I stay at this weight, I go to sleep, and I happily wake up tomorrow and compete, or turn on that tap, get some boiling hot water in the bathtub, sit in there for 2 rounds of 15 minutes to try and shred just a little bit more weight. Pros and cons of the sweat bath. All I can really think of is not getting enough sleep because I'm taking the time to go fill up the bath and all this crap. One other con might be showing up to the competition a little too dehydrated and then having to rehydrate a lot more. But to be honest, I don't really see that too much as a con, because last time we rehydrated like 15 pounds in like 15 minutes. So the pros is that I will be underweight my category, hopefully, by quite a bit, which just puts more points onto my total IPF point score. Other pros, I will be mentally prepared to actually go in knowing that I am in the weight, because even though the scale says 160 here, who knows? Right now, I'm thinking, yeah, we're gonna have to do it. Let's turn on the water. Okay, round one of the hot baths. Oh god. Oh, that's already burning. Oh, that is burning. Oh. Ow.
key with a hot bath is you need to get most of your body in it. The deeper you go in, the more sweat you produce, the more sweat you produce, the more water weight you lose, the more water weight you lose, the easier you're gonna make weight. Okay, so this is a lot harder than we had it. We were prepping for provincials, which is good. Meaning I'm gonna sweat. The plan is to do 15 minutes on, 15 minutes off. Right now we got Patrick over there cutting up some sweet potatoes with one of those really flimsy plastic knives. It's been a blessing having him here, just not only being able to help me prep small things like this when I can't, but you know, record and all the little things that I'm either too lazy to do or I'm just dying from dehydration. Speaking of that, that's one thing that I'm really nervous about doing this path, is just that last time one of these took everything mentally and physically out of me. I was so drained after that. I thought I was gonna die, man. So instead of three times, we're just gonna do two rounds. I'm gonna watch some South Park right now. That's how I time everything. I'm addicted to this show, man. I've already watched the whole entire series, but we're re-watching it right now on season 13. I'm gonna enjoy this pain right here. I'll catch you guys for round two. Okay. So we just finished round one of the baths. It was so much worse than I expected. I started to get that tingly feeling through my body that I got last time when I did the baths, and right now I'm exhausted. We committed to it, so I think we're gonna do one more. I think this time we're only gonna go 8 to 10 minutes, and then right after, wipe off all the sweat, weigh myself, and then do a cold shower to just ice off, relax. And I might give myself just a little bit of water, because we just stepped on the scale and it says 159 pounds, meaning we lost a pound. But who knows, scale might be off in a different plane, right, in a different province right now. Feeling a little delusional. I'm gonna recover and then we're gonna hit round two.
Yo! Hey, I thought you'd be up right now because I'm an hour late right now. How are you doing?
Are you filming me?
Yeah, dude, I thought you'd be up right now, so
I'm on and I'm ready for breakfast.
I finished the first round of the baths and I am dying. Oh my god. Fuck yeah, dude. Cause what happened is I found out that if I lose a little bit more weight, I can be competitive to win the best overall tomorrow. That'd be crazy. Only like one more pound. I weighed in on the scale right now, 159, dude. Last time at like this time of the night, we were like 167. Right now I'm 159. Because you gotta do the water cuts the last minute, man. That's how it works. You can't be dehydrated for longer. But this time I'm almost 10 pounds less than last time. It's gonna be good, man. It's so tough. Dude, can you imagine if tomorrow I step on the scale? Can you imagine tomorrow I step on the scale and I'm a pound over and I fly home not competing and I just wasted all that money? I heard they bully me at assembly today. Damn it.
That's gotta sting.
Yeah, no, that's
gotta sting.
That kinda hurts, man. Well, alright. Whew! 12:30 right now. Just finished the last bath, baby, and that is gonna conclude the last and final thing we're gonna do for this water cut. Thank God, I had no idea it was gonna be this brutal. Still not as bad as last time. The only things we have to do for the rest of the night, oh yeah, Patrick helped me pack already, so that's out of the way. Only things we gotta do is start getting mentally focused to calm down and get a good night, possible sleep. Usually don't even sleep before comp, so we'll see how that goes. And we're gonna record the intro for tomorrow, because once I wake up, there's no way in hell I'm gonna wanna turn on all the lights and record a half an hour intro for a video. So we're gonna get that done. And just want to say,
I'm sorry if this video is super long and boring, but I just wanted you guys to see the raw pain and process that we have to go through. Huge shout out to Patrick for filming. He's going to be taking care of everything tomorrow, so all I get to do is just focus on the meat. Thank God for that. Last but not least, if I don't make weight tomorrow, we're sent home after spending $1,000 coming here, going through all this torture. I just want to say, you're welcome for this video. So, as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all. Hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace!